大家晚上好，很高兴在这里看到你们。A very good evening to all residents, all voters of Fengshan SMC, and all fellow Singaporeans. My name is Dennis Tan Lip Fong. I am the Workers' Party candidate for Fengshan. I will first speak in Hokkien and then in Mandarin before I speak in English. 各位鳳山區的選民，大家好！我是陳立峰，江人黨的候選人。這次大選，希望大家給我一個機會，給江人黨一個機會，替你們做工。做你人的代表，在国会替你人出声，多谢各位凤山单选区的选民，各位新加坡选民，大家晚上好，非常感谢大家能参加我们今天第一晚的群众大会。首先让我借此机会做一个短短的自我介绍。我的职业是律师。我父母是受华文教育的。我在家里跟父母一向都是讲华语。小学时候华校，中学转读英校。1980年大选的时候，工人党前秘书长惹耶热南在智洛布兰雅参选，我跟着母亲去听工人党的群众大会，这个经验使我大开眼界。2011年大选。受到朋友的鼓励，我决定协助工人党在如切单选区的候选人余振中。虽然我从小都开始关心新加坡的政治发展，一直到最近几年前，我都没有想过要参与政治活动。2010年那几年，我国一连串三番四次的发生事故，如暴雨淹水、地铁故障等等，反映了行动党的无能为力，显得江郎才尽。这使我觉悟到，未来的50年，我们不能单靠行动党来带领新加坡，死不得，死不得。我们需要一个多元化的国会，有多种不同思维、不同看法的国会议员，集思广益，从不同角度来一起分析、辩论和解决问题。一党专政的国会容易发生专制独裁、予所欲为的现象。你们自己也有自己的眼睛可以看到，这50年来发生什么事？另一个危险是走入集体思维的陷阱。要避免专制独裁，就必须要有制衡；要避免集体思维，就必须要有多元性。最理想的是，国会必须有一个强大的反对党，提供更多不同的思维和建议，同时也能起制衡的作用，而这是我们当前的国会所需要的。我们现在一个反对党的议员对9个行动党的议员，你说这是对的吗？我们需要有足够的反对党、在野党、国会议员来扮演这个重要的角色。 可惜的是，目前愿意加入反对党阵营出来参选的人也不是很多。我自己是一个土生土长的新加坡人，做过国民服役，跟大家都一样。我热爱我自己的国家，我对他的未来感到十分担忧。你们也知道了，物价高涨，医药费昂贵，房价居高不下，拥挤的公共交通，而且我们经常看到在洗手间骂地，或者是小贩中心洗碗，甚至卖纸巾的老年人。让我们想想，我们的国家到底在做什么呢？这是对的吗？我小时候都没有看过这种情景。我们的国家是不是越繁荣越糟糕？这些问题关系到我们国家的未来，也关系到我们子孙后代的未来。我就是想了这些问题，我就决定说我自己也要出一份力量，所以我决定了参加工人党，出我这小一份的力量。我只是一个平凡人，大家出一小，每个人出一小份的力量，积少成多，这就是人民的力量。我希望奋山选民可以给工人党一个机会，在奋山为你们服务。如果当选，我将尽我所能为居民服务，成为你们在国会的那一把声音。我将以我工人党的同事对政府法案和政策问题发表建设性的意见，我将不会为了反对而反对。各位凤山的选民，请投工人党一票，掌握民权，把握未来。Dear voters of Fengshan SMC, just for tonight, I'll give you a brief introduction of myself so you know who I am. I'm a shipping lawyer running my own little small law firm, which I co-founded 10 years ago. I spent my early years in Jurong and Telok Blangah, and I moved to Marine Parade during my secondary school years, and have been living in the East Coast area since the 1980s.When I was 10, I followed my mother to my first Workers' Party rally, which took place in a car park near where I live. I heard Mr. JBJ speaking for the first time. Politically, it opened my eyes. Since then, I have attended many Workers' Party rallies over the years, through all the tumultuous times of my beloved party. And also in the process, growing up as a student, I developed an intense interest reading about politics, history,And also, I enjoy reading political biographies. Why did I join the Workers' Party? In the years leading up to GE2011, I was like many Singaporeans, unhappy with the policies, worried about where this country is going, and feeling strongly, and I still do feel strongly, that the government, the ruling party, has lost its way. I felt in 2011,And now, even more, I felt that the PAP, we cannot rely on PAP alone in the next 50 years. It's going to get more complicated. There must be a better contest of ideas. The people, that is yourself, must dictate where this country is going, not the government telling you what is good for you. This cannot be a parent and children relationship.You are the shareholders of this country. You are the owners of this country. You tell the government what to do, not the other way around. There is a need for greater political competition. We need more opposition MPs in the parliament. It must be much more than what we have now. One opposition MP to nine.Government MPs, what's the point? It's still not enough. Of course, a lot of things has been done in the last 5 years, but it's not enough. I give you an example. After the PAP suffered a shocking defeat in the Punggol by-election, they have the cheek to introduce the population white paper. Now, everyone is very unhappy about population white paper, okay? We don't need to talk about it, right? But after all this debate and with the PAP MPs trying to express some unhappiness of their residents, guess what? All our Workers' Party MPs voted against the white paper, and zero PAP MPs voted against the white paper. So what is the point of voting one more opposition, one more PAP member of parliament to our parliament? There's no point. And I would emphasize this to my dear voters of Fengshan SMC. But this happens frequently. Most bills are pushed through very quickly. So this is something that we have to change. We have to make the government consider their bills properly, their policies properly. And when there's debate, things need to be changed. It needs more time. Then we cannot rush through the bills. So dear residents of Fengshan SMC, for this reason that I have given above, I hope you give me a chance to serve you in Fengshan and to be your voice in Parliament. Let me be your voice to help you to empower your future. Thank you.